Well, this was a very spontaneous moment. Oh my God, I'm already getting text. I'm not. Be ready to start a live chat video. Oh my God. Facebook just told me. For one day, I turned my notifications on and Facebook just told me, be ready for your live stream called Follow the Money, Create and Destroy. Thank you, Facebook. Oh my God, Mark Zuckerberg, I love you so much. Mwah. Love him so much. Mark Zuckerberg is my soulmate. My soulmate. Then there's this that just arrived. I didn't want a cat. I'm not saying I didn't want a cat. I'm saying it wasn't on my list of things to adopt. And then this just appears. And this is the most ascended, beautiful being. Not more than my dog. Don't go there. You know, not more than my dog. This one, though, holy mother of God, this one is teaching me all about letting go because it's an indoor-outdoor cat. And then I let it out. And I don't know if I'll ever see it again. And sometimes it's gone for 4 days. And then I start crying and getting upset and then thinking about all the moments we had together. And then it comes back. Literally, the night I get sad about, and then it comes back because it wants food. So I'm not saying it's me. I don't provide like lean cuisine. I provide, you know, sometimes I open a can of tuna. Just saying. Anyway, hi, this is my cabin on a vineyard. I'm living the dream, guys. I'm living exactly what I said I wanted. I wanted to be around animals on a vineyard. Careful what you wish for, because I open my door every morning and there's four peacocks, babies, two roosters who they must, the birds must have been talking, you know how that gossip goes. Every morning, I'm nervous to open the curtains. Like, I got curtains because I could wake up and like stare at 18 chickens, 40 roosters, 3 peacocks, and a partridge in a pear tree. And I'm not even kidding because there's 40 fruit trees on the land that I live on. It's crazy. Anyway, this was a very spontaneous moment of doing a live stream. I didn't plan on it, but you know that's how I roll. I don't plan on my live streams. I never, ever do. Because when I do, then I don't make it on time and I feel guilty. It's a whole thing. So let's get right into it. I don't have my glasses on right now, so I can't read the people who are chatting in the chat room. I will say this. I know certain people have passionate feelings about TikTok and that we shouldn't be on it. It's China based, blah, blah, blah. Well, the TV show that I did 4 or 5 years on ABC called The Wildlife Docs was just bought by China. So therefore, should I not accept the residuals that come in the mail? Because China? By the way, I don't get residuals. It was a buyout. But I'm pontificating here. I'm just trying to give you guys like a freedom of speech is important. What we do is important. The fact that we connect with each other is really, really the vein of existence. It's like the blood that flows through all of us. It feels, if we can't find similar people that help us through this dimension we're in, what's the purpose, right? So I have decided that this might be my last YouTube video. My YouTube channel will always be there because I need it. Because when you go to my website to book Divine Detours, the company that I'm running alone, and I need YouTube for that. However, I have found now that during the busy months, oh my God, my company is, it's crazy. It's like amazing. It's like I never thought I could actually be paid to be me. How cool is that? Although I thought the same thing when I had my first YouTube channel and then they deleted everything I said. I'm not even allowed back on Twitter. So I don't know what this Elon Musk freedom of speech is because he never ever allowed me back on. Still trying to figure that out. But I don't care that much to fight the fight because there's more things to think about right now, then I want my Twitter account back. No, I don't care. It's X now. So maybe that's a sign for me that I don't really need to have another platform. But all that to say, TikTok is almost paying my rent. I literally am able to speak and be heard and be funny and do all the things I did on this channel on TikTok. So I know you guys don't want to go on TikTok. I'm telling you, I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just saying that's where you'll find me. And then I'm also going to be starting a Are You Ready to Rumble? The Rumble channel. I will be doing Rumble. I'll be learning how to do it. I purposely blocked off my tours for the next 7 days to refocus, recollaborate, and figure out like how to spend my time the best, which and by the way, hashtag World War III. What's going on? That's going on. I did finally get in touch with someone from YouTube. As I see your comments right now, I'm happy you're all here. Will you please do me a big, 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 big Flavor Flav? And if you were ever unsubscribed from this channel, because I finally got in touch with someone from Google and said, you've taken down my YouTube channel 4 times. Now, when I do any the live stream right now, there's 5,000 friends. One person, like one human being is watching my live stream right now. Out of 5,000, that seems a little weird. Don't you think, Mark Zuckerberg? And YouTube, don't you think that is a little weird? That out of, well, it's not that weird, but 728 subscribers on YouTube. It's so sad because it was 9.1 million. But he's like, tell me your email. What was the email so you can prove to me? How about this? I said, I'm going to go live this week and I would love to record the live stream and just have the chat tell me. Right now, if you could, because I will record this part of this live stream, please tell me if you ever got unsubscribed from my channel, because he wanted proof. He was like, show me you got, why would we, this is what he said in this little chat, why would we ever block someone that only has 728 subscribers? I don't know. Maybe it's because I had a TV show that had 9.1 million people watching me every week and I might have spoken out about or other stuff, maybe. Or I don't know how YouTube, but somehow I have, wait, let me see. Oh, it just went up. Somehow I have 18,000 followers on the TikTok, but my subscription here on YouTube always stays at 768. So if you have been unsubscribed, I'm going to record this. Hopefully I won't say anything that takes it down, but I'm going to record this. So in the chat, if you've been unsubscribed from me or I didn't get the notification, I hear this all the time. I didn't get the notification, Rachel. I'm unsubscribed. Look, YouTube is over. We know this. It's over and done, YouTube. You're done. You are done. But before I exit officially, I would really like you to see the chat room and the people that got unsubscribed from me, the people that we always were a big fan, but all of a sudden you weren't there and all of a sudden you were unsubscribed. So even though it's only a little bitty 728 subscribers, we wouldn't do that to you. Really, YouTube, you took down 4 different channels. This is my last one, and this is the one I give no fucks about. So I'm just asking you, YouTube, which, by the way, I'm going to record this and send this to the guy because he's like, you record it and ask your subscribers if they've ever been unsubscribed. So, guys, please, in the chat room, if you've ever been unsubscribed from me without knowing it, or you don't get notifications, please let me know right now in the chat room. And I'm going to give you about, 2 minutes to do that because I really need you guys to tell me and to prove to YouTube that that is what has happened. Because I've never been able to, I've never reached anyone from YouTube. And I finally got in touch with somebody and he's like, so show me, you're only 728 subscribers. We'd never block you. We'd never silence you. We're YouTube, freedom of speech. Can't say what I'm thinking. Okay. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. But so for 2 minutes in the chat, please, you guys can connect and talk in a minute. Please just say, if you've been unsubscribed, if you feel like they have been shadow banning me, please just let me know in the chat room. I'm not telling you what to say. I'm just asking you a question. That's it. And while you do that, we'll do a 30-second little bit so people can write in the chat room. Has anyone ever felt like they've been unsubscribed from my channel or that I've ever been shadow banned? And go.
Good morning. Sunday morning.
Thanks, General Sorrow. Not to your knowledge. Although they took down 4 of my channels. Did you know that? Not to my knowledge. They took down my $9.1 million YouTube channel. No, I don't know. I didn't know that. Didn't know it. Really? You didn't know that I was actually taken down 4 times on YouTube? There you go. Thank you. And Eddie, I'm telling you right now, although there's one person out of 5,000 on Facebook that sees this right now, that's not weird. One person right now out of 5,000 friends that's watching live, don't you fucking think that's weird? No. Okay. So No Way Thought says, I was unsubscribed by 2 of your channels in the past, just as they shadow banned my channel today. Yes. 100%. Jamie says, yes, I've been unsubscribed from your channel twice. Yeah, Rumble is a good choice because that's where everyone's going, YouTube. Everyone's going there. I'm going to take a portion of this video and send it to the douche that said, we wouldn't ban you with only 789 subscribers. Really? Oh, maybe. My voice is still kind of strong with 18,000 subscribers. Went up 2,000 today on TikTok. So I don't know if you're late to that or whatever, but this is embarrassing to even go live on YouTube because it's so over. Everyone's going to Rumble. And you saw what they did. You saw what they did to our friend Russell Brand, right? Russell, who, by the way, worked for mainstream for a while, just like I did for a while. Then we both realized this is not okay. And then when he got sober, stopped with his philandering, and he's very, very, very open about, even in his stand-up comedy. Yes, he did have a problem with, you know, a little sex addiction, a little this and that. But now he's married to a beautiful woman. They're on their third baby. And he's sober. And he gives speeches about being sober and all this stuff. So now they go after him. Why now? Why now when he was working for you? That's when he was a philanderer. That's when he was a drunk. That's when he was doing all the crazy stuff he admits to. But what he doesn't admit to is ever doing anything beyond consensual situations. And the fact that they came out of the blue to attack him. And the UK... Shame on you, UK. Shame on you. Shame on you for coming after him now and saying, you know what? We think this guy is a little bit, really? Because they got too close to your truth. They got too close to the truth. And he has over 6 million subscribers. So now they're like, ooh, it's getting a little too close to home. We better demonetize him. But guess what? Rumble exists. UK, the governor of UK, like literally wrote Rumble and said, we think he should be banned and demonetized. And YouTube went right along with that. Thank you, YouTube, for going along with no freedom of speech. That's why I don't even go on YouTube. Like, I look on YouTube, I'm depressed. I don't ever, ever even look at anything on YouTube. because it's a dying platform. And you know you're dying because you're taking away what used to be an exciting platform where we could find alternative media to find the truth. You fucking took it away. And you got bought out again, by pharma. Thank you for that. But I'm just letting you know that, there's a lot of people that have been completely shadow banned. And also, one person out of 5,000 on Facebook. Don't you think YouTube, just as you're watching this, don't you think this is a little weird? 5,000, I have 5,000 friends. A TV show with 9.1 million people on ABC, like four-time Emmy nominated TV show, and just one person's watching. Don't you get it? Isn't it obvious to you? If you don't admit it, it's fine. I'm just going to be sending this to you so you can actually see for a fact that this is 100% Wait, what do you say? Yes, good. Yes. Yeah, we're all going to Rumble. YouTube, we're all going to Rumble. That's why this is going to be my last. I don't even want to go live. It's not fun to go live anymore on this platform. It's not. It's literally not. And guess what? I'm making money on TikTok. I'm actually physically making money for the first time in my life by speaking my truth. Isn't that a crazy concept? In America, how can you make money by speaking your truth? You can't because of you, YouTube, and you know it. And you're going down because you got bought out by pharma. And I have been canceled on this platform so many times, I don't give a shit anymore. I really don't. Because now I'm making money on TikTok. And it's more interesting. And I'm connecting with people all over the world. That's why this fucking internet's going to be shut down real soon, guys. Real soon. So I've got about two more live streams I'm going to do. This is one of them. I already told you I don't know when I'm ever going to go live. Because I don't plan when I'm supposed to go live. I'm not led by myself anymore. I'm led by spirit. I know it sounds weird, but spirit leads, and that's what I am. So I'm driven by. I can't help it. It's not my fault, but spirit leads. So I'm going to show you two things, and then I'm going to exit out of here because I'm not doing an all-night thing again. And because it's not fun. It's so much fun when like you get appreciated. Isn't that fun? Like when you talk to someone and they listen. Not saying you guys don't listen. I'm just saying they're shadow banning me so hard that it's just not, it's just, it just sucks the joy right out of me. And when I speak on TikTok, well, guess what? That might have been the psyop to tell you not to go on TikTok. Stay on the platform that silences you, but don't go to the one that allows us to find out information about what's going on with Gaza and with Israel. And this is like hardcore stuff. And when you know in your mind that you're not going to be able to share this on YouTube, I'm ashamed of you. I'm actually embarrassed I ever was on here. Like I will keep the channel just so people can view the video for my, company, but other than that, you are done. You're done. We're done. We're breaking up. I'm breaking up with YouTube. I'm going to Rumble. It's going to be under my same name, Rachel Reinstra, and then I'll have a backup channel called Divine Detours, which is the name of my company. So if you ever want to, I know. Well, of course, that's not in the news anymore either, is it? Not in the news. Not in the news. Yeah. Anyway, they'll be able to read the chat room. I can't read the chat room right now because I'd like to present something so I don't spend all night, do a live stream all night again. But here we go. Oh, God. Okay. Hold on. Let's quick do a, I don't know. I guess I should probably keep this for a message to YouTube as well. My message to you, YouTube, in case you don't speak English. I hosted an animal show, and animals sometimes speak way better than us.
Oh, really? Oh, Pavel. I think you're... You don't care what I think, hey?
I'm fucking awful. I'm fucking awful.
I travel. You certainly do. Oh. But Pebble. I sure hope you're not like this tomorrow. I really. The Pebble.
Hi, Mario. I'm living on a ranch with 18 peacocks. Not 18. Eight. One was run over by a car, which traumatized a lot of us here. And I wake up to opening my sliding glass door to roosters. What's the difference between a rooster and a chicken and a hen? Like, that's something, even as an animal person, I don't know. I'm embarrassed about that, but I love it. 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 I love that I wake up and I walk to the river and I jump in. It's amazing. But since this is probably one of my last YouTube lives, I want to, let's just do the opening, right? The opening that I used to use. And I'll use again, but I'm leaving YouTube, you guys. I'm leaving. It's no longer gonna. I'm not going to be here. It's not a platform. It's like going back to the same douche that you were with, and he or she is still like, just, they don't appreciate you, and they're just like horrible. Why would you ever go back? Why do you try to make something work that doesn't work? YouTube is has shadow banned me. There's one person watching on Facebook, and I have 5,000 friends. 25 people on YouTube, which is pretty good for 728 subs, which never goes up. And that's okay. YouTube, don't think we don't know what the fuck you're doing. Don't think we don't know. We all do. That's why we're leaving you. That's what you did to Russell Brand. He's leaving you too. And you know what? It's kind of backfires because you were actually giving Russell Brand. I'm actually paying Russell Brand now on Rumble, where I wasn't on YouTube. I'm actually paying him to see his content because I get his struggle, and we all do. So what you're doing is actually making it worse for you. So I just hope you realize that. Anyway, we're going to cut to, yes, tonight I'm covering the Israeli war and what's happening, because one of my best friends, who, by the way, I met in Sedona, and he is a tour guide in Jerusalem. On the ground, and I had a conversation with him about what's really happening there, and so I'd like to share that with you, since right now it's up to almost 500,000 views on TikTok, and I'm sure I'll share it with you and maybe be taken down, but it's for entertainment purposes only. In fact, I would like to say, YouTube, that we are all in a dream, and this is not actually anything I share with you true. It's just a dream I'm having, and I'd just like to share with you part of my dream, because it's not true or real. It's fictional. It's all lie, just like the way we grew up. Everything is only as you see it to be. That should help me not get a strike, but it'll probably. Why would we strike you with only 728 subs? Because you already took down four of my channels that had millions and millions of subscribers. That's why, YouTube, you know, give me the email of those. I don't have those four emails anymore. Oh my God. It was just like conversation. I felt happy I could finally talk to someone, but like this. And then I was like, prove to me you're not a bot. And he couldn't. And then it went into a whole other thing. So anyway. This is probably the last time I'll be showing you this opening, so enjoy it. And then I'll cut right to the Israeli thing, and man, I think we'll be done in like half an hour, because, you know, TikTok is only 3 minutes. Can you imagine me, only 3 minutes? Almost makes you want to subscribe to my TikTok channel, doesn't it? No way could Rachel just talk for 3 minutes. Yes, I ish.
There's a lot of people that believe in the Bible. Then what is that? Is that just another one of these stories? Did they copy the Bible, or did the Bible copy them? That pisses people off when you say anything about we didn't go to the moon or flat earth. We didn't go to the moon or flat earth? Okay. Denial is the first stage of grief is denial. True. Really? Would a woman say that?
Well, always part of it. That's part of it as well. That makes you feel, whether it's your husband, your wife, your kids,
they're going to remember this. And so all of us remember that Mandela didn't die.
The reason why it is the frequency of love, it's the common factor that...
Who gets the house? Who gets the basement in the divorce? That's what I want to know.
The moon, every freaking 4 days, it's a super blood wolf, crazy green, yellow, blue, purple moon.
My career would be over if I did that. You see how it's a different game with different choices? This is so much like the simulation we live in right now. I have an experience like where the world's been in lockdown and there's military coming in the residential streets and I was... Maybe a little angry, but I kind of like it. I really don't, because they want us to feel afraid because we're going to be shamed by the normal community of mainstream if you say anything. I don't care. Shame me.
So out of your quiver, you're not ruling anything out.
Good morning. Sunday morning. We have a responsibility. We take an oath to protect and defend the Constitution of the United States. Good morning. Sunday morning. We have a responsibility. We take.
That face. Oh my God, that face will never not be funny. NNF. Hashtag NNF. Before I go into this, because once I go into it, it's going to be like hardcore, because I got a couple of videos I got to show you guys. Like, I'm talking to my friend who's living in Jerusalem, and he's talking about the war, and he was literally there when the alarm went off. And they infiltrated Israel. There's 250,000 views now. I'm sure it'll get that as soon as I share it with you. It won't. And I don't care because I'm not here for the views anymore. I have a business. I'm living happily in a cabin, as you can see, with a... What is she looking at? Like, this is the thing, too. Like, she is looking at something. I've been looking up cats and what they see beyond us, and she definitely... I say she, it's a he. It's a he, and I named him Prince, by the way, because he just walks in, and you are just like, we're so glad you're back. We worship you, Prince. What shall we give you to eat? And then he goes away for like 2 or 3 days, and I'm traumatized. And I'm like, oh, let me die. He puts a guy in my car. What happened? And then he comes back, and he's like, oh, I am not dead. I'm alive. Messes with me because I love this thing. I really do. Spinny's already, by the way, Spinny sang on my tour today. She's already asleep. But hey, Prince, say hi. She's like, always look stoned. And he's like, okay. Are you such a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful thing? Just always looks like totally stoned. Okay, do your thing. Anyway, I got to tell you guys about 10 or 12 days ago, the woman that runs this property, her name is Jackie. She's the real Miss Adventure, by the way. She's amazing. And I can show you video footage, but that's for my TikTok account. The account I get paid to be on. She has such a big heart. She's taking care of her sister who has Alzheimer's and taking care of her husband and this entire ranch full of animals. And every time the sun is about to set, which is like 5:30 or 6 now, she walks and she puts them all in the cage so they don't get eaten, you know? And then she's up at like 5 a.m. letting them out. So she just puts them there to protect them. And you want to talk about free range. Oh, my God, you guys. I'm eating eggs from literally. She's like, you wanted the egg? And she takes it from the hen. And she's like, I'm like, I feel like that's not right. Like, too soon. Too soon. Anyway, she has two dogs that protect the property. They're amazing. And one of the dogs chased a squirrel about 10 days ago and killed the squirrel. But she and both of her and I tried to bring the squirrel back to life. Like I was giving it like harp, you know, it's a animal thing, but you can bring animals back to life if you know CPR. And the squirrel died. And she just like, we had this conversation and both of us were crying and she just held the squirrel to her heart for like an hour. And both of us were just in tears. And there was something about this squirrel that we didn't, we've both seen squirrels die before, but it was just the most intense. And she was holding this dead squirrel on her heart and petting it, you know, even after it was dead. It wasn't her dog's fault, but it was like, you know, it was just, and then she even said, I'm going to put this in the bird cage, hoping that the squirrel would still come back to life. And it didn't, but it was just such a sad and beautiful moment and a reflection of how even in that moment, how precious life is, you know, just even with a squirrel. And I looked at her and I said, there's something about that squirrel. It's going to come back in your next life or something, because that squirrel was, it affected her like no other squirrel ever did. And I just can't figure out why the squirrel was like affected her, because she sees animals die all the time. One of our peacocks was killed by, you know, a driver on the road. And but man, we both cried about this squirrel so much just about 2 weeks ago, and I still think about it, and it's weird. But anyway, I don't know what that means, but the squirrel died in her arms and I tried to bring it back to life. And can you believe this is my life, living on a farm, crying about a squirrel, wondering what that means? Isn't that crazy? All right. So anyway, I'm sorry to bore you with my squirrel story, but I thought that was really weird and I didn't understand why. I mean, the most intense conversation, and she's like holding this squirrel on her heart. And I was just like, it's fucking sad, man. Life is fucking hard. Like when you really start to appreciate and love things, it's fucking hard. And then they die. It's like, I just felt like that squirrel would, it has to have some kind of meaning. Oh, thank you. Was it boring? I think of that Mandela weird. I know. See her in the chat. I know. This cat is teaching me about letting go, I think, because now, well, so now he's gone. Now he's gone. So I do keep the, sometimes my door might be open a little bit so he can come and go, because I don't want to stop him from, oh God, I didn't think I'd be talking about squirrels and cats. Okay, so let me just cut to the, sorry. I really feel like it's, this got way distracted, but I was so intensely affected by her holding the squirrel on her heart, holding it, and it's dead. I know it's dead. We know it's dead, but we're still both holding it, and I was petting it, and it was just like this, maybe this moment of realizing that life is so precious, and that And her dog was the one who was just playing. The dog was just playing. It's a big dog. But just like picking up the squirrel. And I was the one that ran after it. And I jumped on the big dog, like attacked her dog, like jumped on the dog to go, no, because I knew that it was going to get the squirrel. And slow motion, if you would have saw the whole thing, I was like riding on the back of this giant dog saying no. And then when it listened to me and it came back, the squirrel was gone. So I don't know. It's just, I feel like there's a message there. I don't know what it is. Maybe I'm never meant to know what it is, but that squirrel was meant to be here 2 weeks ago. It was like 2 weeks ago. It died. I have dreams about it every night. I don't know what the hell's going on, man. Cause that, I cry when I see squirrels hit by a car, but this one was different. All right. So let's go to, right. I know I can. Yeah. Right. I feel like that. Yes. Yes. Yeah. 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 Hi, Stack. Sorry. I didn't have my glasses on. Anyway. Now there's two people of my 5,000 friends on Facebook. Two are watching. I don't care. Guys, I promise you I make fun of it, but I really, truly don't care anymore because now I actually have a side hustle, which is TikTok. And it's not even a hustle. It's just doing what I do with you guys, but now I'm paid. I am now getting paid on TikTok to do what I've been doing with you guys. It's amazing to me. Next month, it takes 30 days and, you know, anyway, it doesn't matter. It matters, but in the large scheme of things. So I just want to share this with you. That's all. And then let, you know, YouTube know what they've done with banning many of the people that have followed me. So if you ever were shadow banned or not, I didn't get a notification, Rachel. I was unsubbed. I have over four people a day tell me I'm unsubbed from your YouTube. I don't care anymore. But I would like to send this to the douche that I talked to who told me we would never ban anyone that only had 758 subscribers. Really? You wouldn't? Let's see how much video I had to block myself from saying what I was going to say because I would have been taken off YouTube. So you see, I'm editing myself. I'm very proud that I did that. Let's just see YouTube. How many views this video gets in comparison with the channel I started 2 months ago on the Tick and the Talk. I love how people want to trust the government, our government. They want to trust our government more than other governments when our government is Rachel, please shut your mouth. Shut your mouth and focus on 1 minute of what other people hear when I speak. Most of the time. What you said is really important about the stress level, about the children and the babies. And I want you to really, I'm not saying it didn't happen, right? There's Gaza has so many children, and this is not about us against them, right? War never is, but understand the manipulation of the media and understand that they've done this before. and I'm only going to say a couple of words because I don't want to be banned, but incubators and babies. This was something that was very highly pushed in the media a few years ago, attached to another story of a war. I'm not going to get specific because I'd still like to have my YouTube channel up. And by the way, YouTube, this is just for entertainment purposes only and education. Education and entertainment. Nothing I say is true, nor do I ever say it's true. It's only to educate people and inform them and entertain them. So none of this is anything I back up whatsoever. It's all about a dream I had. All of this is about a dream I had. So saying that, Deborah, please understand that this is a highly, highly, highly deep skilled manipulation tactic to make you upset, afraid, angry. And I gotta tell you what, I just told you my squirrel story, right? I was just like, I cry about that. But if I find out, like, and they know it, like, the algorithm knows your weaknesses, okay? When I say the algorithm, I say the things that we look at most of the time, like this, right? It knows your weaknesses, and we're not fighting a war on physicality. We're fighting war of spiritual level, okay? This is way deeper than something. So understand when you see that, they know that that's going to trigger you and bring you in the lowest vibration possible. And they're hoping that you can have that anger and hate, fear. Let's fuck them up. Let's kill them all. This is an example because they know that would. Now, if that same example in my algorithm, I'll get like dog tortured and doesn't matter where. If a dog's tortured or a cat's tortured, animal. Like my weakness is animals. So that's where it gets in. So it's gonna produce the biggest fear for you to watch that. But I'm begging you to somehow, right? Know what we're in. Know that we're in, I'm gonna say Cardian times, but let's just say Revelation. I wake up, I'm like, what day of Revelation is going to be? Know your weaknesses and know that they have no power over you. And even seeing something that's tragic, but you're not going to allow it to lower your vibration. In fact, you're going to meet that. You're going to process it. And you're going to say, that's true, but... And then you have to fill in the blank, right? And that's your work, because... It's so easy for us to be manipulated, even subconsciously. We're creators, right? We're creators. We were made in the image of God. So God is the biggest creator. We're creators. But if you're not consciously creating, you're subconsciously creating. But the trick is this. Before you're seven, this is why many religions say, give me a child before they're seven and I'll own them the rest of their life, because there's subconscious programming that's programming you right now and you don't even know it. But if you're not conscious about your programming, if you don't make an intention about what you allow in your life, well, then you just lean back and go, oh, God, I'm just going to watch the media, the mainstream. And all of a sudden, boom, they're programming you. But you have the power. You have the power. They've just tried to figure out when you're lazy and you don't want to own your power. They figured out how to get in there in your mind and control you. Keep you in the state of fear, which means you're going to buy that next pill. You're going to be more programmable, and you're going to be completely owned by the powers that be. But they know their time is running short. YouTube, your time is already done, by the way. You're already done. Rumble, get ready to rumble. Yeah, cool. So I'll be there for a while, but TikTok is where I'm making my money. And I'm meeting so many amazing people around the world, you guys, around the world. I'm getting my media, not from YouTube anymore, because YouTube is owned by Big Pharma, and you guys know it, and you're still here, and I appreciate you. I appreciate you for being here. But I cannot in my heart and my spirit, I can't support this platform anymore because it's evil. It's not who we are. And I know it's easy. It's easy for me to do a live stream and get two people on Facebook and 20 people on, but I don't care about numbers anymore. It's not what I'm about. I'm going to a platform that actually I reach over 200,000 people in 3 minutes. That's where I'm going. I'm sorry. Whatever they told you about TikTok, whatever they wanted you to believe about TikTok, TikTok is supporting free speech, although many people are getting taken down as well, but it supports free speech way more than this platform. This platform is at this point, I believe, this platform is no longer sustainable for someone that's in integrity with who they are. And Russell knows it. That's why he went to, you know, he had to be forced to go to Rumble. And, you know, Jimmy Dore, it'll happen soon to him too. Trust me. He's my ex. He knows it. It's coming. It's coming. He's getting too close to the powers that be about the information he's allowing out. Oh, God. Having said that, I'm sorry. I just really went on a rant. I'm not really sorry, actually. But let me just share. Yeah. So let's do it. Here we go. So this, let me give you an example. So this is my TikTok. I want you guys to look at the viewers I'm getting right now, and YouTube, I'd love for you, because I'm recording this and I'll be sharing this with Douchey Van Doucherstein from Google. Look at this. How is this possible that that was yesterday. 7,000 2 days ago. Let's go here. 169,000, 131,000 views, right? I did hit the jackpot right there with the community standards violation, but 6,000 right there. 1,300, right? This is, I'm not showing this to say, oh, look how we're at. No, I'm saying, understand YouTube, we see what's going on. This is a platform. They say, oh, China, don't go there. They're telling you not to go there. Why? Because your government's telling you not to go on TikTok. Because that's where you're going to get the real information, guys. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for you guys that don't believe and don't going on it. I get it. You were sold out exactly the same way we all were with many different things. So all I'm saying, you don't have to go on it. I don't care if you go on it. It's up to you. I'm not about that. I'm just saying, what the fuck? Because they're allowing. Why? Because guys, there's something called the Dugin Report, and I don't know if you guys, you're probably not ready for that, and I'm probably not allowed to share it, but I'm going to save that for later. It's just in the next, from 2017 to 2025, it has a report of every country and the amount of people that are alive and are not. In America, 70%. And by the way, this is just a dream I had. It's not real. Look it up. 70% of Americans are gone. And that's according to a report that, oh God, I can't say it on YouTube, but just look up. I can't even say it. Well, you have to look on TikTok because I can't say it here. And I really don't want my YouTube to be taken down. So let's just do this. I talked to my friend who's on the ground in Israel, and we'll just do that. Here we go. Before I say something I shouldn't. Here we go. And go. I said I had this dream last night. We're at war with Israel. And it's World War III, blah, blah, blah. I freak out because one of my best friends lives in Israel. So I called him, and this is the conversation. Please record this in case it gets, you know what I'm saying? It's really important.
Okay. Okay, tell your people in America, the Israeli government and the American government sold us.
This is 100% for entertainment purposes only. This is just a script. It's a movie. We're all in a movie. And what you're about to listen to is simply for entertainment purposes only. TikTok. I'm not saying this is what happened. I'm just saying I talked to a friend who lives where it happened. And this is his version of a movie we're all living in. This is only for entertainment purposes only. Look, it's just a cat video. See? Just a cat video. TikTok. Cat. So.
People in America, the Israeli government and the American government sold us. They left for the Arabs. Empty way to enter and kill everyone in the South area. Nothing like that can happen in the reality. Just if someone helped that to happen from inside. And it's more than, it's not just help them. They are stupid Arabs. If you give them maps, directions, tell them where is the base, it's not going to help them. You need to do the job for them. I think some of the jobs, some of the kidnaps, some of that, I think it's the Israeli secret forces done it.
Why would...
It doesn't make sense.
No, it doesn't make sense unless they're working inside against their own country by either being paid off or whatever. I mean, look, it's happening all over America. You know that we have this incredible crisis with the immigration. So, yeah, are we being invaded without us knowing it?
Yeah, they do it on purpose.
And they're doing it to you too, but it sounds like they did a lot quicker.
No, in here they're doing something else. In here they want to open a war with Iran, they want to open a war with Lebanon. So they need a big excuse for the war. That's what they done. Now they have the excuse, like, they have the... They say that terrorists attack us, we have to defend ourselves. That's what the stupid Biden said yesterday. We understand. That's how it works. You need to give excuse for the war. And yeah. Not only to the war, mostly to the stupid people watching the news. Because no one cares, honestly. No one cares.
How are you handling it locally? What's happening in your world? Like, there's, like, what are you guys, what are you going to do?
We had a meeting last night, few friends. We're going to watch the things where it goes, and we're going to act. We have nearly everything ready already, you understand? So we don't need to buy stuff or things like that. Maybe a bit more food. All the rest we have. We buy accessories for 3 years. We prefer a plan for 3 years. We expect for this thing for 3 years. It's not surprise us.
All of a sudden, I had this dream last night. We're at war with Israel, and it's World War III, blah, blah, blah. Perfect example. Good night. Whoever wants to leave, you're welcome to leave. Love you. Glad you were here. I'm just showing you when you just saw that video, right? And you saw the amount of comments right now, that video, it's almost 500,000, all right? And now, right now, the three people on Facebook, 18 people, it's bullshit, guys. You have a bigger voice than you think, all right? And guess what? I'm not upset about the numbers. I know my voice will be heard because I'm an authentic spiritual being that's, you know, having an amazing experience in this earthly plane that I apparently decided to come to. But, yeah. Oh, my God. No way. I didn't even know I had a Rumble channel. I should probably click on that. I must have started that, like, years ago when my previous self knew what was going to happen. Thank you. I love you. I'm so glad you're still in my life now. I'll do one more. If you're tired of Israel, that's fine. I just have a friend that lives there, and this is the, it's up to 170,000 views. Why does that matter to me? Because what this person on the ground says in Israel matters, because you don't need to be listening to CNN or NPR or Fox. You need to hear the people that are on the fucking ground. That's who you talk to. That is where you get the information. And that's what I believe in. Other than that, you're a sellout. You're too lazy to listen to the actual news. And fine. So go with that and you'll be programmed and good on you. But I'm going to share part two. Because it's important. Even though there's 17 people now and 3 people on Facebook, it's such a fucking lie. YouTube, you suck. You're over. You're done. Just like Donald Trump. You're done. You're canceled. You're bad. You're not a part of me anymore. I don't need you, YouTube. Oh my God. It is a little bit of a comedy, this whole fucking shit show we're all in. But having said that, I will have to share this. Because it was accepted on TikTok. Not only accepted, it was shared, and over 500,000 people shared it. So, you know, if you're not interested in listening, I'm fine with that. Go to sleep. Happy with that.
I'm talking to my friend from Israel. What's really happening there? And by the way, TikTok, this is just for educational purposes only and entertainment. In fact, it's actually really just a dog video, right?
Yesterday I was in a synagogue. We had a holiday. In the middle of the Torah reading, we just finished the Torah. It's the holiday. We finished to read the Torah after 1 year. I'm standing with the chief rabbi of the old city, and the sound of alarm in Jerusalem, it's something pretty rare, because most of the time they don't shoot to Jerusalem. Yesterday they shot tons of rockets to Jerusalem. They shot them to every city in the country. And then I start to walk during the Shabbat and the holiday. I'm not touching the phone, I'm not using electricity. And people talking about renovation of like the invasion of the terrorists from the border in Gaza. And I thought they making a joke. Listen, this situation can never happen. They can't cross the border. It's something impossible. There is 3 borders full of army forces, tanks, and whatever you can imagine, standing on Gaza border. And they have an excuse. No, it's a holiday. People went left to the vacation. No, I was in the army. No one leave for the holiday. In the army, people stay 24/7. Someone opened for them the border to enter to Israel. They killed people. They kidnapped people. They took the control on a few settlements. They burned them. And people ask, where is the army? You see the groups of the settlements, the WhatsApp groups, they talk to each other. Where is the army? Where is the police? Where is the army? Where is the police? Where is everyone? They kidnap us. They kill us. And no one come. You can imagine what I'm talking about. I try to send you the videos, but the WhatsApp don't let me send those videos from yesterday. It's like automatic system block these videos, because in these videos you can see Arab terrorists on jumping on bases of the army. And there is no soldiers against them. Like, they left everything empty and escaped.
This video is part 2.
So, by the way, 3 people on Facebook, 17 people on YouTube. You know what? F you all, because this is still getting more publicity. It was shared 3,000 times. This has gone viral all over the world, and YouTube will not even allow right now on this live stream 3 people on Facebook with 5,000 friends, 70 people. So this is also, I'm also doing this video. I don't give a fuck right now, because ultimately I'm going to record bits and pieces of this just so this douche that I talked to that said, you're not canceled on YouTube. Really, 500,000 people watched that video. And on YouTube and Facebook, it will not be shown. Why would that be? Ask yourself these questions. This is what frustrates me about all of society, is that nobody fucking cares. And if you don't care, I'm going to tell you what. If you don't care, it is going to come to you, because we are in a world war And if you don't think we are, did you watch? Did CNN show you the incredible group in Iran who are screaming? Do you know what they're screaming? Do you know what they're screaming? At the parliament, thousands and thousands of people. They're screaming death to America. In my dream that I had last night, which is only for educational purposes, it's not really about this YouTube video, it's just a dream I had last night. They are screaming death to America. In my dream that I had last night for educational purposes only, that is the facts right now, people. So if you think you're just, oh, I'm just going to go about my day. Who cares? No, don't get enraged. Don't get engaged with the stuff they're sharing with you because you're lazy. You're lazy. You're not really watching what's going on because you're not willing to call someone that lives in Jerusalem like I did. Find out what's going on the ground. Not what they're trying to manipulate your mind into feeling, because you have to understand, guys, this is not about just the Middle East. And they haven't, you know, they've been having conflicts. As long as we've been alive, they've been having conflicts. Palestine, free Palestine, Israel, we're for Israel. You know that's been going on as long as we've all been alive. But guys, this is not the same right now. It's not the same. And you know it. It's not the same. It's escalating to a point where you and your family, and when you have an entire country, like Iran is chanting, and this is yesterday, chanting, screaming at the parliament, death to America, and you right now don't think that's going to affect you and where you are. God bless you. God fucking protect you. I used to do live streams and I would make people laugh, and I still want to do that. I truly do. And I'll do that on Rumble. But guys, it's escalating to a point that it's not to stress people out, but it's to make you realize, don't get fooled into the propaganda of us against them. Understand that, just like my friend on the ground said, on the ground, it's not about that. It's not about that. He literally said it's, and they know it, on the ground. They know, and they're prepared for 3 years. They literally have food. He's walking around with a gun with 36 bullets in it. Like, can you imagine? That's your life. That's your life. But he said, we came here for this time. He is a very deep spiritual person, and he does truly believe that. And I know. That's why I talked to him about it. So I'm going to end it with this. And I'm going to, obviously, I'm using YouTube like they used me. So I'm going to use this as a chance to edit this and then put it on my TikTok tomorrow, because no one's going to see this. My YouTube channel might be banned after tonight. But if it is, I'll sue them, and they know that because I'm recording everything. Very, very, let's just say I did a lot of research about how to handle my YouTube channel with people who have been on my tour and have given me advice. So that's all I'll say about that. Having said that, I would like to just share with you, follow the money. I've told you guys this my entire life. The only thing I've ever told you, no, not the only thing, that's a lie. Please follow the money, follow the money, follow the money. But if you can't follow the money, this guy breaks down everything that's happening via following the money. Okay, so I'm going to end my live stream with this, because this is the best information I could ever give to anybody. Whew. It's pretty. I can share something else, but I don't want to confuse you. I'm just going to go into follow the money. This guy, the moment he got on YouTube, by the way, I love him. I watch him every day because I know now when I go grocery shopping what to buy and what not to buy, because he follows the money of every single corporation that, like this. Like, this is a Wild Tonic, right? It's kombucha. And it is a local company. I know, I've been there. I know what they put in it. So I'm happy to drink this. But You go buy spices. It's owned by a signature. You go down the grocery aisle, the dog aisle, the cat, the, you know, whatever aisle. He follows the money and he literally shares with you what to buy and what not to buy so you don't support big corporations. This is, again, what I learned on TikTok. Where is TikTok the enemy? How is TikTok the enemy? It's giving me so much information. I've learned how to garden. I've learned how to cook new meals. I've learned, and I'm getting paid to share my information. How is this bad? They fooled you into thinking that this is bad because the government doesn't want you knowing this shit. That's it. That's it. All right. Whew. Here we go. I know it's going to be a little confusing for the first few minutes. Only, I think it's 7 minutes because TikTok, you know, it's not like my live stream, 8 hours and I fall asleep. But this, please listen and watch. If you're falling asleep or whatever, watch again tomorrow. Please, 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 please. Because this guy he's incredible. And he's also making his living now just researching corporations and what to buy and what not to buy. This is how we can do. You know how you always feel? Well, just you share me all this stuff. I feel so upset, depressed. What can I do? I can't do anything. Yes, you can. You can listen to a guy like this and know when you walk out down the grocery aisle what to buy and what not to buy. Because the stuff like Annie's salad dressing, it's not fucking Annie. It's not. It's BlackRock. Most of everything you buy is owned by them. And you're not going to hear about it on TikTok. I mean, you will hear about it on TikTok, but he tried to do a YouTube channel and they took him down immediately. He's gone from TikTok. I mean, gone from YouTube. He's on TikTok and he's on Rumble. And this is information. And I listen to him every day because when I go grocery shopping, I don't know what to buy anymore. Now I do. So if you're tired, you don't want to watch it, it's fine. Please, please listen to this because he follows the money on everything. So his channel is called Cancel This Conspiracy, which I love the name of that. And we've messaged each other a few times, but now he's so booming all over the place that he was like, it's hard to get a hold of him now because he's becoming, which is beautiful because that means people are waking up and they're wanting to listen to this. So this is awesome information. Here we go. And this has to do with the war that we're involved in. Here we go. All right. Go. No way you're going to love him.
Weapons, some grenades, some improvised rockets and mortars and stuff. They got some anti-tank and some anti-aircraft guns. In 2011, Israel estimated that they had several hundred members who'd received military training. Oh, babe. And let's be clear. I condemn violence against civilians unequivocally on all sides. No one has any right to commit acts of war against unarmed civilians, period, full stop. That's my opinion. Let's get back to numbers. Israel, on the other hand, they have about 170,000 active troops. And they got 615 heavy infantry fighting vehicles, 2,022 medium or main battle tanks. They got 196 F-16s, 83 F-15s, 36 F-35s. Oh, and 142 attack helicopters, including 43 Apaches. They got 5 submarines. So don't go trying to swim away from Gaza. Obviously, they got their Iron Dome situation. They got 49 battleships. Oh, yeah, and they got some really big bombs. And by really big, I mean nukes. Yeah, but don't get it twisted. Hamas has a couple hundred dudes that received military training. And they got some grenades and some improvised RPGs and shit. So how the heck did Israel come to afford all of these tanks? Well, we give them several billion dollars every year. From 1949 to 2014, it totaled up to $118 billion of basically just all military aid. But we figured that wasn't enough. So now we're about to give them $2 billion more, just, you know, because it's an emergency. Because we figured this many tanks wasn't enough to defend their borders against the terrorists. Just real quick, if you weren't aware, in the year 1850, the area was about 3.8% Jewish. In 1878, the Ottoman census called it 3% Jewish. This dude and some homies came up with Zionism basically around 1900, end of the 1800s. This whole concept was not a result of the Holocaust, despite what you might have been told. The Balfour Declaration, which established the concept of Israel, was presented to Lord Rothschild, you know, the banker, in 1917. It had nothing to do with getting help winning World War I, but the British did simultaneously promise the Arabs a state in Palestine if they would turn on the Ottoman Empire at the Anyways, that's a difference. So all the Jewish people started moving there to Palestine, and by 22, it was 11% Jewish. By 45, it was 31% Jewish. This 1931 census of Palestine really clearly shows, though, that of the Muslims, basically all of them were born in Palestine, 98% versus 1% that were from elsewhere that had moved to Palestine. But of the Jews living in Palestine in 31, 58% of them had moved to Palestine, and only 41% had been born there at that point. Which is just a little bit of context for when the UN, after World War II, decided that, like, okay, here's Palestine. Now let's divide that up fairly. So we got, like, 31% of the population, give or take. Let's give them 56% of the land. And most especially this part right here that's, like, really important for international trade. Then, you know, there was, like, a little war, and then it ended up being more like 78% of the land. But, you know, another little war, and it wound up being, like, 100% of the land plus some extra bonus parts. Which, you know, they later gave back because it was really, you know, like, trying to be nice. And actually, because the state of Israel was so nice to the Palestinians, they actually later gave them back 18% of the 22% that they'd wound up with as Zone A in the Oslo Accords, where the Palestinians could actually govern themselves. But the rest of it, they figured they would just settle in and just, like, move in there and, like, demolish Palestinian homes and build Israeli settlements, despite that being illegal and the UN condemning it. And then promising, like, no, we totally won't do any more of that. Like, not at all. We'll come back to this in just a second. Because let's be real. Like, the Israeli military needs all of these weapons and tanks and bombs and helicopters, etc., to protect themselves against the jihadist Muslim terrorists that have been killing them since they just wanted a free place for them to live. Namely, the place where the Muslims lived. In fact, the death tolls have been so high among Israelis that, like, you can actually see the bars on this graph. You want to know why U.S. news and U.S. politicians are always talking about how Israel's getting destroyed by terrorists and how Israel's the underdog and how Israel needs our help and we're so unequivocally behind Israel? Well, here's a list of all the pro-Israel PACs, political action committees, that have given this much money over the years to people in Congress, etc. You notice, like, an increase in lobbying recently? Interesting. We're talking like $40 million plus per year. It's going to Democrats and Republicans alike, although a little bit more to Democrats, especially lately. Homegirl in the House has received more than $1 million just in the year 2021-22. Damn, girl, you're not even on any important subcommittees. What are you up to? $1 million contributed from Israel. For who knows why. Israel, if you give me $1 million, I'll take this video down. Just saying. This is a graph of the average campaign contribution to members of Congress over the years. You notice anything interesting going on here? But let's be fair. There are also pro-Arab PACs that also contribute to Congress and lobby the government. Because, you know, we're fair. We're just looking at the numbers, and the numbers don't lie. Since 1992, total, all these pro-Arab PACs, they've contributed more than $1 million. I mean, come on. Like, literally, since I was born, they've contributed over $1 million. I mean, that's, like, literally a little bit more than Chantel Brown has received just last year. Just Chantel from pro-Israeli PAC. Total, since 1992. And this is from all the pro-Arab PACs that they could possibly dig up. And by they, I mean I'm literally using the Jewish Virtual Library as my source for that. But let's be real. Money has been a big part of the equation ever since the start. But just in case all that wasn't enough to get this video taken down and my account banned, let's go one step further. You know how not only did they somehow take Israel by surprise, but also it took like 8, 6, 12, 20 hours for the Israeli military to respond in several circumstances? And I mean, you can go and read the articles about Egypt warning them and whether or not what. But Let me remind you that a certain dude was massaged, allegedly. Read Whitney Webb's book, allegedly. They had power over many of the most important people in the world from many different countries. Power they may have acquired through many different ways. Multiple islands were literally bought for this operation. And you know, like a weird temple was built too. I don't know. TikTok, FYI, those are all very publicly available facts. Information reported in major news headlines. That is not misinformation. You cannot, yeah, we're supposed to believe that they didn't just not know about the attacks, but it took them this long to respond. And you might believe that if you didn't know about the kind of technological surveillance state that Israel has already implemented. Why would Microsoft be really into doing cloud computing, cloud data centers in Israel, investing a lot in Israel? Why would Israel be a hotbed for digital innovation and entrepreneurship? Gosh, cloud computing, so great. Customers' data being one of their strongest assets. And they have face scanning cameras. They have a database on all Palestinians. It's literally a phone app that Israeli soldiers use to scan faces. They then get tracked biometrically by cameras and sensors all over Palestine. Israeli soldiers have quotas of how many photos they have to take per shift to add to the database. This is publicly available information if you just look for it. You can listen in on any telephone conversation, and they do so actively looking for pressure points and blackmail. Quote, I know people who are doing time in Israeli prisons merely because of their social media activity. But you expect me to believe that they did not know about this fighting force training for an aerial invasion? Anyways, that's all I'm going to say. You should do your own research. And if you want, you can find me over here, that name, where I've been doing my research, and I just put up an hour and 14-minute video about it, which I was actually researching and putting together completely unrelated to the current attacks. And I posted it in my locals community, actually, like a day or two before the attacks. I'm only going to leave this up on YouTube for a little bit. I would really appreciate it if you go follow me over there, because this is where I'm going to be posting all my long-form content in the future. YouTube ain't into it. If you want videos posted early, you want the inside scoop, direct access, you can join the locals community for free. Or if you're down to support the work I do, you can support for $5 a month. That's awesome. I just want to say one last time that I condemn violence against civilians, no matter who's perpetrating it for what cause. This video is in no way meant to justify the Hamas attacks. The loss of any life is tragic. But most of all, pay attention to the rhetoric. Pay attention to the fear mongering, pay attention to the calls for conflict, and think, who's going to benefit from this war? Who's going to profit? History doesn't start the moment you start paying attention. A lot of people have opinions about Israel.
I fucking love him. I absolutely love him. I love him on so many levels. For what he's doing at his age and how he's brought together the truth by following the money. And he did it just as a joke. He was like, had a TikTok channel. He was like, let me just go down the grocery aisle and find out who owns what. And then he was like showing you. And by the way, on TikTok, you can see he has videos only under 3 minutes that you can see what products to buy when you go to even Whole Foods. So, he's a warrior, like, in my mind. So I knew he was going to blow up, so I messaged him before that, and I said, please, please, please keep me in your, like, private messages, because you're going to, like, the information he was giving and the research he was doing. So now he's literally making a living off telling people the truth. Can you believe it? Could it happen? Yes, maybe. Maybe it's possible. Maybe. Anyway, Taz, I'm so glad you're here. I love you. I'm so happy that you're here. I'm just going to share one more thing because I know that was a lot. That was a lot of like technical information, but also he's following the money. He's actually going back in time and following like who gave money to what program and what, you know, how it all works. And we all know where it leads. But, and even I was watching it and I was like, I kind of lost focus because it was very, you had to really like sit there and listen. But I want to share with you an emotional video that went viral, like crazy viral on TikTok and on Twitter or X, which I'm still not allowed on. So until Elon Musk give me my channel back, I still am 50-50 on him. Is it good? Is he bad? I don't know. but my gut says he's good, but I still can't get my channel back. So, and I only have a 752 subscribers, YouTube, right? Douchey douche. So why would I be a threat? Why don't they just give me my channel back? I'm such a silent person. It just doesn't have anything else to say. I've got barely any subscribers. Why would you shut me down? Because now I'm up to 18,000 subscribers on TikTok. It was 16 yesterday. I'm going to be the closing act. Promise you. I'll be a part of the closing act. It won't be me. I will be a part of the closing act. That means when all this shit show happens and the war is going on and whatever, there's going to be a moment I won't be silenced anymore. I'm not allowed to say what I should say, but I think we're in a play, and this is, I'm just not supposed to be the time will come where the words I say will actually resonate and reach many people. But right now it's suppressed for a reason. I believe in that reason. All right. So let's I fucking love this guy. I might end this live stream with just him because it's so good. And by the way, YouTube, this is a dream I had. This is an actor who's just playing a role. So what I'm showing you is an actor playing a role for auditioning for a movie. So YouTube, please don't take this channel down because this is just me showing you, and I have full rights over this video I'm about to show. I'm trying to like figure out how to not be taken down. YouTube, I've read your policies, and I am in a lawsuit with you right now. Hashtag, you will only not help your lawsuit by taking this video down, but you can do whatever you want to do. I just wanted to say out loud, this is only a movie and this is an actor. I'm going to show you guys an actor who is just giving you words from a role that he is auditioning for. This is an audition. I am showing you my friend's audition. That's what I'm doing. That is exactly what I'm doing, just for educational purposes and entertainment purposes only. Oh, it's exhausting. You love America. Free speech. Feels so free, doesn't it? All right, there you go.
Let me get this right. You want to pass a law to draft my daughter to send to another one of your foreign fucking wars for something you've created.
He's an actor.
So your arms
actor.
Manufacturers actor. Can make more money for your banker friends. Did I get that fucking solid right or not? Now, wrong, elephant breath. My daughter will not be joining the military any way, shape, or form unless it's to fight this fucking war that this government has started against its people. See how simple that is? The very fact that you don't understand the societal fucking rules about women and children, let me school you a little bit. Now, the fact of the matter is you can't make your fucking recruitment numbers because your recruiters told so many lies like, oh, yes, you get the condo on the beach when you join up. Oh, you get to start here, but we're going to switch you to what you really want later. And the biggest boner up the ass, the VA will take care of you if you got hurt. Hey, the reason you can't meet the recruitment goals is because these young men have already voted with their fucking feet. They're not going to fucking fight. And the fact that you think you're going to get the women to fight, let me put it to you this way. It was one thing when you oppressed us with unbelievable fucking taxes. One thing, because we were living in nice homes and still eating pretty good. It's another thing when you spied on us to the degree that you did and made us realize that we don't have any freedom. It's another thing when you not only wrecked the fucking economy, but you fucking did it in such a way where you spent so much fucking money that went to special interest groups that the people never had a chance to benefit from it. And now, when you have people that are homeless eating canned goods out of the back of their fucking car, you know what? They may do that for themselves, but they're not. Their kids are not going to go through that. Motherfucker, you're going to find out what people will do for their fucking children. You protect women and children because it's the societal norm. It has nothing to do with being sexist or unequal in any way. The fact is, you should always protect people that are weaker themselves and always stand up for the right fucking thing. And the right fucking thing here is, if my daughter is going to be in a war, she's not going to have to go to a fucking foreign country to fight it. Fuck your taxes. Fuck your withholding. Fuck your FEMA. Fuck your IRS. Fuck you. Fuck your corrupt Congress. Fuck your corrupt presidents. Fuck your entire election process. You know, I could go on forever, but let's face it, the world's not going to live that long before a fucking meteor solves a problem for us. So fuck you. And if anybody doesn't like what I'm saying, you know what you can do. If you do like what I'm saying, give me a hell yeah in the comments, because our women aren't going to fight a fucking war for some corrupt fucking government.
How do you not? How? Sorry, can't find that on YouTube. How is that not the best thing ever? It was in my feed on TikTok, and I was like, I literally woke up to it, watched it, played it again. I put it on loop, like a loop, playing again and again and again. Because it's like, you know, that guy doesn't ever swear. Like, normally that guy for sure does not swear. And I'm watching this guy because he's like, don't you think you're going to send my daughter to the war that you're... It's like... I love him for saying that, doing that. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. This is again, like YouTube for me, and I think all of you, YouTube used to be the place we went for alternative media. Like, we're like, you can't watch CNN or Fox. So we go to YouTube, and we would get the same high from people that would say stuff like he's saying, but you can't do that on YouTube. Douchey, 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 douchey YouTube person that I'm going to show you. By the way, Taz, you got on here, but about an hour ago, I was like, can you please tell me, has anyone been silenced or told that they're unsubscribed from my channel? And I had about 15 people go, yes, I was. In general, so I was like, not that I know of, but I've been on here for, I'm going to say 8 years, and I had 9.1 million followers at one point, and that was my first channel. So I actually messaged the YouTube guy and I was like, so what's going on? He's like, well, show me, do a live stream and ask your followers if they actually got unsubscribed. So I'm asking you, show me, did you get unsubscribed? So I'm doing this live stream for two reasons. One, because I need to just get it out. And the other one is because Douchey needs proof that someone was unsubscribed. Not someone, hundreds and hundreds. I get emails every day going, where are you? I'm trying to find you on YouTube. YouTube, you're done. You're over. You're canceled. You're canceled. Done. Rumble is where I'm going to go. So I'm letting you guys know I'm doing this so I can edit and show him the few people that actually admit to the fact that they were unsubscribed. Because he didn't believe I was. He was like, why would we block anyone that only has 728 subscribers? Why would we ever unsubscribe people that could do this? Because I had 9.1 million just every week watching me on ABC. Then the second time you took me down, it went from 9.1 million to 10,000. And then went down to 4,000. And then it was down to 728. And why can I prove that? Even without anybody on this fucking planet knowing that I had an ABC show, blah, 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 who cares? TikTok, 18,000 subscribers. Without them knowing, I don't even mention out loud what I do, where I went, and that didn't matter at all. The moment I started speaking the truth, what happened on TikTok? People started listening and they were subscribed because YouTube bans anyone that speaks the truth. And you proved it with the Russell Brand. You proved it, didn't you? You literally showed your true colors. And that's why I came on here to do one of my last live streams, because I cannot physically, spiritually, mentally, emotionally be a part of YouTube, which sucks so hardcore. But they're like, oh, it's hard to leave YouTube because I go on live right now and I see the ones that have been with me for the last 5 years. So it is hard to leave, but I'm going to Rumble. I want to figure out my Rumble channel. I know, I think I started it like 3 years ago, but I didn't know I'd have to go there, but now I have to. I have to, because I cannot spiritually support a channel like this that I don't even go on YouTube to watch anyone anymore. I literally don't. Like, if I want to learn the truth, I don't go to YouTube. And YouTube was like, I would go to YouTube, go, okay, CNN, let me go to YouTube and find out the real truth. And now Pharma owns YouTube. So you sold yourself, motherfucker. You sold yourself out. And you know who you are. And I'm going to record this. I'm going to let you know. Once again, the truth will never, ever die. And you can play the game and do all that, but we are not here for money or for likes or for any of that shit. I did all that fucking shit. I did it in my 30s and my 40s. Yay, cool. Four-time Emmy nominee. Yeah. Who fucking cares? Right now it's about the truth. I don't care about likes. I don't care about I'm happy that TikTok has actually monetized my account. Isn't that weird? Isn't that weird? TikTok, owned by China, is actually funding the truth. But America gives me, oh, let's look, 16 right now watching me, and 4 on Facebook. You guys got to understand, if I went live on TikTok right now, there'd be thousands and thousands. I don't care about the numbers. I'm just saying the difference. Wake the fuck up. YouTube is controlled by pharma, and so is Facebook. I have to be on that because I own a business. I have to be on that. I'll connect with people randomly on Facebook. That's okay. But the truth is, YouTube, you are done. You are so done. And the fact that I even had to do this live stream to prove to this douche that I reached out to, where he's like, show me, why would we cancel anyone with 728 subscribers? I know why you cancel someone that has seven. You gave me 728 subscribers because, as proof, I started a channel 8 months ago on TikTok and I have 18,000 subscribers, 500,000 views on something I just posted 4 days ago. So fuck you, YouTube. You're done and you know it. And I'm going to edit this and send this to the douchey douche who's like, prove to me that anyone unsubscribed. You didn't have any subscribers. What was your channel before? Fuck you. I promise you know. I know you heard of Google, and I know you can look me up because I know you can find out how big my feet are. Probably find out, like, how many breaths I take. Like, you literally own everything, and you're telling me right now, why would we cancel someone with 728 subscribers? Because you fucking know my voice has power. And you do. And that's why I'm leaving this platform, because you are done. Done. You're Denzel Washington. That's kind of fun. I like that. I like the reference. I just like to say, you're Denzel Washington. Right? 100. Right? Yep. Oh, look at this. Been following you since 2015 or 16 via YouTube. And where did I go? Isn't it weird that I had 9 million subscribers? Then it went to 40,000 subscribers. Then it went to 728 subscribers. Because YouTube, you're a sellout. And guess what? I pray for your soul. Because karma is a bitch. Karma is a bitch. You will get what you actually put out. And I can't wait. I hope I don't die before I see what YouTube gets in the karma area. Because anyone that even works for YouTube, you will get it. You will get it. We're in the age of, you know what apocalypse means? It doesn't mean the end of civilization. It doesn't mean zombies. It doesn't mean bombs. No. You know what it means? The unveiling, the truth, putting the curtain. And then say, oh, it's just the old guy pulling the fucking... You've seen the Wizard of Oz, right? That's the truth. The Wizard of Oz is the truth. And you are going down so fucking hard and fast. And the fact that you even question me about the foot, you can look me up and know you've taken down my channel. I'm going to say four, but it's probably been like eight times. But it doesn't matter because I'm not going to be here anymore. And I'm doing this so I can clip it together and send it to the douchey guy who's like, show me her. We would never block someone with such a little following as you. Then why the fuck do I have half a thousand people watching my videos on TikTok owned by Gina? But if you really follow the money, it comes back to America. So it's not owned by China, by the way. Follow the dude who says cancel this conspiracy. He goes down all the rabbit holes and he follows the money, which just means the truth. And sad as it is, the truth is backed up by the money. That's Yep. Okay. So now 11:40. All right. I'm gonna wait one more Okay, this one, have to. Oh, man. Grandpa, angry grandpa with his thing. I don't even know how you could ever get better than that. How? It means revelation of the master of his house, thoughts don't care. Yeah. I mean, I will go live on TikTok for sure. I just want you guys to know I'm leaving this channel soon. I'll be on Rumble and TikTok. TikTok, I can't do, like, unfortunately, I don't know why, although I kind of do. I can't just go. I wish I could. It'd be way more fun on TikTok to be like, oh, something's wrong. Something wrong.
We have new information now also on the plane crash. KTVU has just learned the names of the four pilots who were on board the flight. They are Captain Sum Ting Wong, Wee Tu Lo, Ho Li Fook, and Bang Ding Ao. The NTSB has confirmed these are the names of the pilots on board Flight 214 when it crashed. We are working to determine exactly what roles each of them played during the landing on Saturday. And very- That's
all, folks. Can't do that. Not on TikTok Live. So I would invite you guys all from this point on to look up the Deagle Report, all right? So I was going to share that video tonight. That was the most important video I wanted to share. And I'm going to show you when I wanted to share it. What happens when I want to share that? Ready? Share that. It's like, nope, this. So this video currently unavailable. My God, I knew it. I knew I should have shared it earlier, but so. The Deagle Report. Maybe just look that up because I'm afraid I'll get taken down if I even talk about it. But let's just say that there is a report that comes out about countries and their. How many people are living in the country, and it's a report. It's never been wrong, and it's just a report showing you, according to the numbers, what's going to be the amount of people alive in 2025. And the report, again, never been wrong, based on monetary stuff, and I gotta be careful on YouTube. Anyway, I'll do it on my TikTok. I don't want to get taken down because it's gonna be that would allegedly in my dream what it said was 70% of America will no longer be here. So that's basically, yes, yes. The Deagle Report. Yep, 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 yep. That's it. I can't say anything more now. I'll say it on my TikTok tonight, but thank you guys for being here. I'm going to end it. And 11:44, I was hoping to end at midnight, but what I wanted to share with you is no longer available. That can't be, it cannot not be available. How is that not available? Okay, well, I'll do this. You know what? I got it. You know, this is called In the Moment. So, thousands and thousands of views on this one. And if you guys have been with me for a while, you'll remember. But I love that I repurposed it, found it on Odyssey, because that backed up all my shit when they took me down the first time, YouTube, which was in 2018 when you took me down the first time. So I repurposed it, put it up on TikTok. That's why I'm now making money on TikTok, because I thought, wow, it's got zero views on Odyssey, no views on YouTube. Now, 500,000 on TikTok, and I want to make $500 next month from this video alone, which I repurposed, and you might remember it, you might not, but it still holds value and truth. I even watched it and went, what was this really a thing? And yeah, it was. So let's hold on, sorry, I'm trying to figure out how to share it with you. It's not working. Maybe I shouldn't have been. I shouldn't have bragged about it so much, because apparently it's not gonna let me share it. Stay here. Even if I'm gone, stay here. I told you to stay here. I told you I would be back. All right. Apparently, what I'm trying to share with you, they're not allowing it, but I got a workaround, guys. I got a workaround. So give me a second for the workaround, and then I'm going to end it. But this is why I feel like when I do a live on TikTok, I can't finagle and do all this like workaround, but when I do the workaround, I'm trying to at least entertain you with something. So during the workaround, you're like, oh God, I could, you know, have a moment. God. Okay, here we go. 30-second workaround. Go.
You can really dance. Wow, you can really dance. He went. They said we've both been dancing all this time. What a coincidence. Wow, you can really dance. Wow, you can really dance. He went. They said we've both been dancing all this time. What a coincidence.
My favorite one. It really is. That's my problem with doing a live. My problem with doing a live on TikTok is I can't do this shit. Like, I can't do like this. This is so brilliant. I love this one.
I'm gonna go get my vaccine and get back to my prime.
Well,
life never seen a vaccine made in quite so little time.
No, I'm not getting the vaccine, Dr. Oz.
We're gonna plan insane events like we couldn't do before.
I was like, man, a lot of people were hoping that this product would allow them to be free, would allow them to drop the fear, would allow them to go back to public events and concerts. That's what a lot of people were hoping. Does getting the COVID-19 vaccine stop you from spreading it? Scientists don't know yet. Pfizer and Moderna are gathering more evidence about whether vaccinated people can still spread the virus.
Once everybody gets their shots, the 20s, they will roar!
Face masks and social distancing measures are here to stay even after the vaccine. That's according to the top infectious disease expert in the U.S., Dr. Anthony Fauci.
I just can't wait for vaccines.
Well, vaccines are completely unnatural.
10 million people and more have the flu vaccine, and how many people per year catch the flu? You know, I'm not getting the vaccine, Dr. Oz. I'm not. I don't trust it.
No more need to stay home. No.
Everyone, whether vaccinated or not, continue to avoid medium and large size gatherings, as well as non-essential travel.
I did my own research.
No more isolation.
With space.
Should continue to avoid medium and large size gatherings.
No more need for face masks.
Should continue to wear a well-fitted mask, physically distance.
I did my own research.
No more isolation.
With space.
No more need for face masks.
People who have been fully vaccinated should continue to wear masks and
with immunization
and practice safe public health precautions, just like people who have not yet been vaccinated.
Free to socialize all day.
But our travel guidance currently has been unchanged.
No more COVID in our way.
Why are you getting your vaccine?
No.
No.
No. I'm not getting, no, I don't trust it. There, I said it. Yeah.
Yeah, she said it. Do you guys see a pattern with people like speaking out about vaccines and then them never, like, they're gone? I'm willing. I will absolutely 100% be okay if you take me out right now. I'm fine. As long as I let you know not to ever do it. I'm fine. As long as someone takes care of my dog, I'm fine. That cat was going to be fine. You know, didn't need me, but trust me on that. Do you see a pattern? Do you see a pattern? Yeah, silence forever. She's done. She's done. They have literally erased her from society. She is overdone. Her career is done. And the thing is fuck you. I don't need my career anymore. I'm fine doing what I'm doing. So they can't take that away from me. So don't take I'm all about it. But I cannot believe people do not see the silencing that takes place with that. Anyway, so this is a video that I repurposed and I'm going to continue on my TikTok channel. Called TikTok Rachel Reinstra. And there you'll find out my Rumble channel, which I have to like redo because I don't even remember my password on the Rumble channel. So I just can't, in my integrity, I literally cannot do YouTube anymore. I can't. I won't sleep at night. It won't be. I'll figure out how I can move to other places, but this is not, it feels like I'm giving in to the, I'm not getting paid. It feels evil to me. And what they did to Russell Brand, this is another reason why I can figure out how to share the truth, which by the way, as of next month, I'm making $350. From sharing the truth on TikTok, just from talking to my friend from Israel about what's going on with the war, just me being real, not performing, not being funny, just actually giving truth, and I'm getting paid for that. Isn't that what America should have been, but we're not? So, Anyway, this is a repurposed video from, I'd say 5 years ago. zero views on Odyssey, 2 views on YouTube. On TikTok, it's paying my rent-ish. Okay? So, same video, just so you know. I'm being very clear, just so you know. Same video. This is, and I watched it going, the previous Rachel, I'm going, God, you were good. Previous Rachel, holy shit, you were bringing the fucking goods. I was bringing the goods. Oh, okay. They're not going to let me share it. Oh, come on. All right. It's happening again. Hang in there. I'm not giving up. They're doing a thing. They're trying to block it. So hang in there. I'll be right back. They're trying to not allow it. Hold on. Probably should have said, fuck you, YouTube. That was probably my bad. By fuck you, I meant, I love you. Let's make love. In a way, you could take it as fuck you, but I was saying, like, let's make love. You know, some people view it as fuck, some people view it as love. You know what I mean? It's like, they took it the wrong way, I think. Ish. Here we go. I got it now.
I think it's going to get any weirder. I've had like 18 what the fucks in the past hour. This is going to blow your mind. And if you don't think we're living in a matrix, if you don't think we're living in the West world, you're totally wrong. And I'm going to show you. I'm going to go live in about an hour. And I'm going to like take
previous Rachel.
Why we're in West world because yeah. We are in West world. We are in a movie.
Yes, we are.
We're in a movie. We're literally
in a movie.
I get predictive programming. I get when they do movies that's kind of similar. Like, you know, Pandemic comes out the same month that there's a pandemic. And, ooh, Parasite wins the greatest Oscar, the biggest Oscar, the number one Oscar. It's a shitty film, but it's called Parasite. And the directors, everyone's from China. I can handle that. But what you're about to see, I have words, obviously. You have a lot of them, but you have to watch. And I apologize. Get over the swearing, all right? You got more things to worry about other than swearing. What you're about to see is going to blow your mind. Maybe it won't. But this, to me, proves that we're in the West world, okay? It's already been posted. It was posted on Instagram earlier, and I took it. And I'm sharing it with you guys because I can't believe this. Oh, my God. It's going to start with a CNN reporter that we see. I think it's Sanjay Gupta, which is the CNN reporter for health. And he's talking to the camera, and it's real time, like tonight. He's on CNN talking about the coronavirus. Then this guy realizes that he just watched the pandemic movie, and it's the exact same thing, word for word, scripted, social distancing, all that, all right? Just watch, okay? Just watch, watch.
Reporting on CNN about the coronavirus.
Pass away from the coronavirus. Everything we are doing right now is to help
now our check this shit out. Now look, this is Lawrence Fishburne in the movie Contagion. Listen to what Blood say.
But right now, our best defense has been social distancing. No handshaking, staying home when you're sick, washing your hands frequently.
And look who Blood talking to.
To date.
Ain't that the nigga from CNN? Or am I tripping?
We're still working on confirming that number.
The
CDC, this is Blood from CNN in the movie Contagion. Come on now. I mean, I ain't no conspiracy theory motherfucker, but this is a hell of a coincidence. And he telling us to do what we got to do right now in real life in the movie.
Is that in order to become sick, you have to first come in contact with a sick person or something that they touched. In order to get sick.
I mean, the same guy says CDC. And it's not an actor playing the CNN dude. It is the CNN dude in the movie. With Lawrence Fishburne, same word for word. What is happening? What the f- Previous Rachel, you're amazing. I love Previous Rachel, right? So great. It's so crazy. And the fact that that got, I mean, I was like, oh, this is still, you know, it still holds true to right now. Previous Rachel is fucking amazing. Do you love Previous Rachel? No thing is coincidence, right? Yes. Right? Previous Rachel says, love this. Previous Rachel says, thank you for sharing. You're welcome, Previous Rachel. I fucking love you, Previous Rachel. I'm insulting myself. All right, I have to end this. I do. What's happening to my hat? There's some hardcore, like, doesn't matter. Point is, or I just, oh my God. For me, it validated the fact that that was a really good video. And it got like, I was just like, let me just try this. I'm gonna just post a video that I posted like a couple years ago when I got banned the second time, YouTube. And I went, let me just play this. And I'm like, oh my God, thousands of comments. People are like, oh my God, this is so interesting. Sorry, but it validated my existence with all the fucking work I've done on these videos my whole life. And nothing has ever actually validated it. Ever. Which is fine. Ish. Not really fine. Kind of lying about that. But all right, let me see if I can do one more. One more. That was fun for me. Fun for me. Maybe not for you. Now there's 7? How? 19 people. It says right now. I gotta take a screenshot of this and show you. Because you guys can't see it. I have to. It's my obligatory right now, there's 21 people watching me on the YouTube. Yes, I said YouTube. And 7 on Facebook. I've got to show you this. I've got to show you the numbers. The numbers right here. Oh, it just went down to 20 because I said YouTube. Uh-oh. Sorry. Right here. Look at this. Look at this. Right now, this is 20, and then 7. It's so cute. It's so cute. So cute. So cute. So cute, YouTube, because you guys are done. You're over. We are. The world of YouTube is over. It's over. I will absolutely support TikTok China. Yes. China already bought SeaWorld, which TV show I did. Oh, so China bought that. That's what I'm going to do. Love playing with the Matrix. That's it. Just playing with the Matrix or aura distancing. I don't even want to take that down. That comment is so, in fact, I can screenshot it because I won't remember it tomorrow because I have many funny thoughts every day, and that I just have to aura distancing. That's it. Done. For the Marburg that they're bringing in next pandemic. Aura distancing. Because I'm in Sedona. That's so perfect. Oh my God. My new channel might be called Aura Distancing. We have to laugh or it's not going to work. If we don't laugh, then it's done. We're over. It's over. We're done. And it's sad. I can't do this on any other live platform, which is why I don't want to go to the other platforms. But I'm going to play this and then one more thing and I'm done. I say that all the time. You know that. Probably not true, but. Or this. If you don't listen to this information and integrate it in your life, it's on you. 3, 2, 1, go.
Step 1, train the people only to consume. Step 2, infiltrate adults with the news. Step 3, indoctrinate the children through the schools and the music and the apps on the phones that they use. Step 4, separate the right from the left. Step 5, separate the white from the black. Step 6, separate the rich from the poor. Use religion and equality to separate them more. Step 7, fabricate a problem made a lie. Step 8, put it on the news every night. Step 9, when people start to fight and divide, take control. This is called situation.
Very true. That's the art of war. China actually makes their children read The Art of War. The Art of War has to do with, like, literally being, it's not about violence. It's about understanding the enemy. And then infiltrating their country while they're focusing on fighting. What do you think is happening right now? Why do you think this whole thing with the millions and millions of people crossing over the borders, most of them just men of military age? Do you guys understand that we are actually being invaded right now? We're being invaded silently by open borders. By the way, I think that they are doing what they're told to do. So I'm not, I have empathy for all of it. Like, but we are being infiltrated quietly while you guys are fighting against each other. Where you guys are like, Democrat, Republican, Trump, Biden, stop. That's what they want you to do. They're winning every single time you have a fight or argument with someone. They win. They win. They win. They win. So ultimately, I was going to share one more thing, but I just realized that, nope, I've got to tell you this. This is... I can give you as much information. I can show you my friend who's on the ground in Jerusalem right now. I can give you every bit of information and show you how many times I'm trending on TikTok. I can do that. I totally can do that. And it doesn't do anything for me at all. Nothing. What I can do is end this live stream, probably the most important advice you'll ever need. Ever. Whether you're a Republican or Democrat, whatever you are, this is what I leave you. And if Arizona is bombed tomorrow and we are not here anymore, which, by the way, death is not real. It's only energy cannot be destroyed. So there is no death. What do we be afraid of then? How shall we be afraid? No, what, you shouldn't be afraid. That's what they want. How do you win the spiritual war? Well, I was going to show you other things, but my intuition just told me to end the live stream with this. Because comedy transmutes and alchemizes what logic or even presenting facts to you, which you obviously, some of you can't hear because you're like, but Fauci loves me, but the government loves me. They have our best interest in mind. It's okay if you believe that. I'm not here to convince you otherwise. I just realized the only way I can end this live stream is with this. I think some of you know I'm going to play. Some of you don't. But Douchey Van Doucherstein YouTube, by the way, because I'm leaving you. I'm breaking up. We're ending this relationship. I just got to, you know, let my people know that I will not be here anymore. It's over and done with. But Rumble will be the new place. Rumble. Go Rumble. Go Rumble. If you don't want to do TikTok because you still believe that China owns TikTok or whatever. I'm making my living on TikTok. And I appreciate Go China. I'm going to go China. I'm all about China because our government has lied to us about everything and they don't have your back, my friend. They don't have your back. In the dream that I had last night, which is not true, and I'm just fabricating, and this is just for educational purposes only. And the fact that I have to fucking say that. And there's 21 people watching on YouTube and 9 on Facebook. The fact that I fucking have to say that this is for educational purposes only means we don't have freedom of speech. And you guys are pussies and no one does anything. No one does anything. And guess what? The ones that are silent while they know what's going on, you will have a karmic debt, my friend. I pray for your karmic debt. I fucking hope that your karmic debt is not as bad as I think and know it will be. Because the ones that are silent and know what's going on, you guys are fucked. The ones that know what's going on, like me, and speak, well, I'm fucked for sure in this reality. But I'm also taken care of. I'm living in the dream place. I prayed. I just want to live with animals on a vineyard with the creek and mountains. And it's happened. It's happened. And it didn't mean because I'm blessed or what. No, because I know that I'm protected. I am protected. And anything and anyone that threatens that will have their karmic debt to pay. And that's fine. I just have to continue to be truthful, honest, with good intentions. And you will absolutely get fucked if you do that. You will absolutely. The universe does not support that right now. But trust me on this, because I died in a river in 2017 in Costa Rica, and I came back to life. And I can tell you right now, the ones that are lying, the ones that aren't being true, the ones that are not being real or authentic, you will have a price to pay. And I'm just doing what I'm told to do because I already died. I died in 2000. And I have 3 people that were there that saw me and I was dead and I was brought back to life. So I don't need to prove it. I'm just telling you guys. I'm giving you information that's not popular, but I don't fucking care anymore because I already left. And my time here, this is just for fun. I already know what's on the other side. So I get to play with the universe now and have a little fun with it. Still, it still hurts. I still feel pain. I'm still, you know, but it's not what you think. Like when you die, yeah, it's a whole different ball game. But I did leave. I was dead and I came back and, you know, I'm here now, not for me, but to do what I'm supposed to do. And that's not for me to say. So anyway, someone just said, play the song. Just like, I don't know what song you want me to play. I want to end it, but I want to that link. Hilarious song, that link. You said it to me on my text? All right. Taz wants me to play a song. All right, so I'm going to do that. Taz, it's a... All right, here we go. This one. All right. I'm gonna play this. All right, hold on. All right, here we go, Taz. I'm gonna end with your song and play the advice I give to everyone. Oh, this is perfect. See how it works? See how it all works perfectly? So we are going to start with the advice for the human race and end with the song Taz sent me. So here we go. All right. I love this. See, I don't know if I can do that on, like, you know, when you're on live, on, you're like, oh, I'm just talking, and it's just, I can't cut the things. It's, you know, I'll still do it, but this is fun, like, to, you know, share shit that people send me. It's, I don't know. I'll check it out with Rumble and I'll figure it out. Anyway, I love to read what you're, I can't with my, on my glasses, so without my glances. All right, so let me cut to this. All right. And give me a second. Just green. Yes. All right. And then my advice to the world right now. Everyone watching this, my advice is this. Go.
Mr. Switzer?
Yes. Come in. I'm just washing my hands.
I'm Catherine Bigman. Janet Carlisle referred me.
Oh, yes. Still being buried alive in a box.
Yes, that's me. Should I lay down?
Oh, no, we don't do that anymore. Just have a seat. And let me tell you a bit about our billing. I charge $5 for the first 5 minutes, and then absolutely nothing after that. How does that sound?
That sounds great. Too good to be true, as a matter of fact.
Well, I can almost guarantee you that our session won't last the full 5 minutes. Now, we don't do any insurance billing, so you would either have to pay in cash or by check.
Wow, okay.
And I don't make change.
All right.
And go.
Go.
Well, tell me about the problem that you wish to address.
Oh, okay. Well, I have this fear of being buried alive in a box. I start thinking about being buried alive and I begin to panic.
Has anyone ever tried to bury you alive in a box?
No, but truly thinking about it does make my life horrible. I mean, I can't go through tunnels or be in an elevator or in a house, anything boxy.
So what you're saying is you're claustrophobic.
Yes, that's it.
All right, well, let's go, Catherine. I'm going to say two words to you right now. I want you to listen to them very, very carefully. Then I want you to take them out of the office with you and incorporate them into your life.
Well, shall I write them down?
Well, if it makes you comfortable, it's just two words. Most people can remember them.
Okay.
You ready?
Yes.
Okay, here they are.
Stop it!
I'm sorry?
Stop it!
Stop it?
Yes, S-T-O-P, new word, I-T.
So, what are you saying?
You know, it's funny. I say two simple words, and I cannot tell you the amount of people who say exactly the same thing you're saying. I mean, this, you know, this is not Yiddish, Catherine. This is English. Stop it.
So, I should just stop it.
There you go. I mean, you don't want to go through life being scared of being buried alive in a box, do you? I mean, that sounds frightening.
It is.
Then stop it.
I can't. I mean, it's been with me since childhood.
No, we don't go there. Just stop.
So I should just stop being afraid of being buried alive in a box.
You got it. Could go. Well, it's only been 3 minutes, so that will be $3.
Actually, I only have a five, so.
Well, I don't make change.
Then I guess I'll take the full 5 minutes.
Fine. All right. Well, what other problems would you like to address?
I'm bulimic. I stick my fingers down my throat.
Stop it! Nut of some kind? Don't do that.
But I'm compelled to. My mom used to call me fatty.
No. No, we don't go there.
But I've been having this dream.
No, we don't go there either.
But my horoscope did say...
We definitely don't go there. Just stop it. What else?
Well, I have self-destructive relationships with men.
Stop it! You want to be with a man, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm, yes.
Well, then stop it. Don't be such a big baby.
I wash my hands a lot.
That's all right.
It is?
I wash my hands all the time. There's a lot of germs out there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, don't worry about that one.
I'm afraid to drive.
Well, stop it! How are you going to get around? Get in the car and drive, you kook!
Stop it! You stop it! You stop it!
What's the problem, Kathy?
I don't like this. I don't like this therapy at all. You're just telling me to stop it.
And you don't like that?
No, I don't.
So you think we're moving too fast, is that it?
Yes. Yes, I do.
All right, then let me give you 10 words that I think will clear everything up for you. You want to get a pad and a pencil for this one?
Right.
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right, here are the 10 words. Stop it or I'll bury you alive in a box.
One of the reasons I love doing lives is because someone will send me something in the chat and I'll actually be able to share it. So Taz, thank you. I just watched, like, I was laughing. I was doubly right ear listening to Bob Newhart, left ear listening to what you sent me. Oh my God, this is so funny. Can't wait. I can't wait to end the live stream with this. So thanks for tuning in. It's been, what's so weird is that there's 10 people on Facebook, 17 on YouTube. You know what? I've taken the next 4 days off so I can figure out this whole internet thing and get my, I'm making almost as much as my tours by going on TikTok and doing what I do with you guys. So I would love to figure out how we can all, like, if you don't want to download TikTok, I'll go to Rumble. So I'm gonna be developing my channel in the next 5 days. I'm telling you, I'm taking my 5 days off to put energy into the other thing that I love, which is this, which I do, and you guys know it. Thank you for being here. I literally feel like it's kind of therapy for me. And you know what? Like, you know it. But thank you, everyone, for being. And if you don't believe in TikTok or not, I don't care. But I just thank you for still showing up. And I'm going to end this live stream with what Taz just sent me. I don't know where you know. I don't know where you found it. But, you know, I'm going to repurpose it on my TikTok. And, yeah. So let's do it. Do it. Bam on, bam on, bam on, bam on, bam on, bam on. Here we go. And by the way, thanks for being here. Even when back in the day, I got off Ambien, which I miss Ambien because I used to shop so well. Like, I bought, like, this table, like that table right there, that glow, that was, I bought that on Ambien. I don't remember, but I'm a good shopper on Ambien, and I miss that. I miss my Ambien shopping. What I don't miss is falling asleep in the middle of a live stream, right? Like, oh man, I know someone still has that footage. I literally fell over, hit my head, and you heard me snoring. Like, that's, I mean, that is the most beautiful footage ever. And if someone has that, I'd love to have that footage just to cut to, you know, oh my God, are you guys tired? And then cut to me just, you know, because it was a moment. That was a moment. It was a beautiful, honest moment, which most people would be ashamed of. And I'm kind of like, who's got that video? So I can make fun of myself. If you can't make fun of yourself, you're really not in the right reality. You're just going to be miserable here because you can't make fun of what you do. You're going to take life too seriously. That's a horrible place to live, because good luck living through the next 6 months with that. Now, having said that, let's cut to the video that Taz sent me. Thank you very much. We're going to end with this and share screen. Let's go. Roll it, roll it. Bam on, bam on, bam on, bam on. Here we go. This is my jam, is what it's called. All right, here we go. All right, so wait. Illuminati.
We want to get into the Illuminati because we want to get invited to the coolest parties. By subtly communicating hidden symbology, soon we'll be part of a secret society. Hollywood will open up its doors for us. We'll meet the inner circle of executives. We'll give a guy a tea in a warm jacuzzi, and the guy will put us in a Disney movie. Then they'll play our music on MTV. We'll be given designer clothes for free. And we can drive everywhere DUI because we'll be under the protection of the all-seeing eye. And we'll never have to worry about bills again, because the Rockefeller family will be our best friends. We'll fuck your squirrel and finger a fish and triangle I pyramid. You can be rich and famous too. I love the establishment. Yay! We want to get into the Illuminati, and we want to hang out with Jay-Z and Beyonce. We want to sell our souls in a billion records and bow before our reptilian overlords. Then the enlightened few will bring us into the fold, where we'll be told secrets of old, like why the CIA killed JFK and why on Earth the moon landing was fake. Being Illuminati will be so much fun. We'll learn the truth about Area 51. They'll tell us where Flight MH370 is and which politicians like to fuck kids. We'll get a million followers on Instagram, we'll have the whole wide world in our hands. The Rothschilds will take us to Bohemian Grove, where it's likely that we'll both be murdered and cloned. Let's manipulate the economy. War is good for humanity. We're gonna get assassinated for making this video. More like initiated.
All right, I'm totally going to make a video on TikTok tomorrow with that. So, if you can't look at TikTok, it's going to be a shame, because it's going to be a really good video. But you left, Taz, you have to text me the that link of me falling asleep, because I think that should be the end of every single live stream. It's just me going, and they're like hearing me snore. It's fucking brilliant, 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 brilliant. I support it, but I'm going to bed now. 10 people on Facebook, 17 on Facebook, 17, YouTube, 10. Oh, Lord, Rachel Meenstra falls asleep during live stream. Oh my God, can we end that with that? Oh, it's so horribly amazing. Oh my God, who wants to make fun of themselves? Me, I do. But it's there. I see it there, but it doesn't come up on this. Oh, Jesus. Okay, hold on. If you guys want to see me falling asleep to Ambien like 4 years ago, it was like during lockdown, maybe. Oh my God, this is horrific. And at the same time, I never want to lose this. I never want to lose it. Right? It's a popcorn moment. We're ending this live stream with a popcorn moment. 33 seconds, you're going to see me fall asleep to ambient. Oh my God. Here we go.
You know, they say if you can't say anything nice, don't say anything at all. I'm sorry. Okay, keep going. I don't know where that came from. Go ahead. Oh, I think there's a K in knucklehead.
Oh, granted, I was listening to Bamon, which we know. I mean, there's two people I fall asleep to. Well, three. Quantum Conscious, which I love. Love, love, love. Subscribe to him immediately. Immediately. Quantum Conscious. His voice just sends me into, like, I can clean my entire apartment or I could fall asleep. But it's a familiar voice. Yes. I think we've been doing this for 6 years, guys. I hate to say it, at least six. So this is me listening to, I'm ending my live stream. I think it's during lockdown and I definitely took an Ambien because my God, that's the only way I could sleep during that time. I would say right now, just walk away. You don't want to see this. You do not want to see this. Or maybe you do. Maybe you do. Maybe you do. It's so horrific. It's so... Mag Bitter Truth. I did fall asleep to him many nights because he made me laugh. And what's a better thing to do than if you can't have sex and go to sleep, you can laugh and go to sleep. That's the best ever. But this was just horrible. And that's why I'm proving to you that I can laugh at myself. Here we go. Oh my God, this is so horrific. Rachel Regan falls asleep. Here we go. This should be trending on TikTok, I would think. Only 538 views.
Melania Trump, don't forget it. It's a man in a drag. 100% in. Don't fool the people no more. I break down this one and I'm going to repost the video and show you. That's a man in a wig. That's Melania Trump. Million and a half people take a look at this.
Hear it.
Take a look at this right here. What is he pulling on the dude hand for? He trying to pull him in to hug him? See that? He's pulling,
Yes.
Watch his hand sign. That's the 666, the mark of the B style.
Look at my dog. Look at my dog. My dog's like, where is she? Is she okay?
They're going to give him another term to continue the agenda that they got for him. You understand? The establishment put him in there to work on the people brain. And I already told you that's a one. Take a look at this right here. That's a man right here in a wig. That's how they do it. Pay attention.
Done. Proof that I can make myself fall asleep. Oh my God. Rubber babies. That was the best Meg Bitters conspiracy ever. Rubber babies. That was how I could fall asleep during that. That I'm concerned. Saddest part was like my dog going, where is she? Let me help her. Oh my God. Oh God. Let's end it with Spirit Lee. Let's end it with the thing we always I long for the moments that I fell asleep like that because I've stopped taking Ambien like for 2 years. I don't take it anymore and that's why I don't sleep. But I promise I'll never fall asleep. I love it. I encourage making fun of myself because it humbles me too. I miss Ambien, but I do believe it does kind of cause Parkinson's and, you know, a little bit of a, not where did I put my keys? It's like, where am I? You know, I have enough of that now. I don't need to encourage that with pharmaceutical companies. Just take this pill and you'll go to sleep. No, you know what? I'm okay. I'm interesting enough to listen to boring people that will help me go to sleep. Maybe I'll do that tonight. Tonight I'm going to go to sleep to Mag Bitters, Rubber Babies. If you haven't seen it, it's a great video, by the way. By the way, we didn't even cover Suzanne Summers dying. My God, Chrissy from Three's Company. I have to process that.
Now, are you two ready for the results? Okay. The paternity test determined you are the father.
Dude, that was Fauci. I'm so embarrassed. Someone sent me that as well. I did not know. I needed the work at the time. Wow, that was... Ugh. Okay, one more video. I'm going to be sad not being here anymore because this is fun. I've always had fun. It's going to be sad. My last live stream is going to be so sad. This is, well, I might do two more because I'm off this week, but it's going to be sad not doing this with you guys because, you know, I'm a bit much. You know I'm a bit much. I'm a bit much.
This occurred to me that I might be a bit much. Like, I think maybe if I met myself, I think I might be like, yeah, he was nice, but he's a bit much. This occurred to me that I might be a bit much. Like, I think maybe if I met myself, I think I might be like, yeah, he was nice, but he's a bit much.
This is a pandemic of the unvaccinated.
Get vaccinated. Go fuck yourself.
If you're fucking happy and you motherfucking know it, clap your motherfucking hands. If you're fucking happy and you motherfucking know it, clap your motherfucking hands. If you're fucking happy and you motherfucking know it, and you really motherfucking want a motherfucking show it. If you're motherfucking happy and you motherfucking know it, clap your motherfucking hands.
What's the best way to wake up?
Best way to wake me up in the morning is to never fucking do it in the first place. Oh yeah. Best way to wake me up in the morning is to never fucking do it in the first place. Oh yeah.
And what you see will be.
Point is, I'm going to end this now, but I really, really want you guys to get boosters. I want you to get as many things that are tested on 3 mice, maybe 10 mice, 10, I think it was 3 mice and then 10 mice. They tested on 10 mice, no humans. And we don't know what happened to the mice. But I would say to you guys, please get your vaccines, get your boosters. Should you get your booster and your vaccines?
No.
That's not fair, guys. Seriously. It's been tested on 3 mice. Like, the latest boosters, according to the World Health Organization, it's the latest booster has been tested on 3 mice or 10 mice. Get it. Protect your grandma.
Hell no.
Come on.
Tell the no. Tell the no.
That's upsetting to me. Get it.
States. My fellow Jamaicans, our nation is in a crisis. The Decepticon variant Hobo 19 is still killing fat people. Inflation is destroying our fart jars, and now the Ukraine is being sexually raped. That is why I've asked Congress to order a full-scale attack on Joe Rogan. Not Joe Rogan, the Russian guy. The guy with the shirt. Pootie Tang, man. He's a bad dude. We gotta come together, man. Get this guy. He's got our cranes. He's got all the cranes. We need him for the better build back. The build back better plan, man. You say it 3 times fast, pal. You say it. God, piece of shit guy over here. Anyway.
If that is not funny to you, whether you're a Republican or Democrat, I'm just going through this stuff going, I won't be able to do this on live stream, on Rumble. This is fun. This is fun. It's funny. It's funny. Guys, come on. Republican or Democrat, I don't care what you are. If that does not make you secretly laugh, like inside, you're like, I don't want to laugh, but I gotta laugh. And then 15 years ago, one of my first moments doing stand-up, swine flu. Roll it. Bam on.
I cannot watch the news because I always think that I have whatever epidemic is out. I thought I had swine flu because I thought swine flu meant eating like a pig and then throwing up. Hello. I've had swine flu since college. All the girls in my sorority had swine flu. Do you know what? I understand. You ladies in the room, you want to throw up to look good? Fine. Go for it. Do it. But what I don't understand is all the fake beauty in LA. You got the fake boobs, the fake lips, the liposuction, the plastic surgery. I mean, it's ridiculous. I'm from Michigan. I come from good stock, and I'm the real deal. I mean, what you see is what you get. And I got to tell you, I lived in LA for like 13 years. No, 13 years now. And I have to tell you, LA hasn't affected me at all. You know what I mean? I cannot watch the news because...
I think I almost got canceled. All right, guys. Good night. Don't shut up. Isn't that funny that I did that? stand-up comedy like 10 years ago. So insane. And you know what's even more upsetting is that there's that same bit. And if you look up Rachel Reinstra's stand-up comedy, it says, you must have sex with me or all this sex. And I don't even, it's rated G. All my comedy is rated G. But they'll get more clicks if the clickbait is everyone must have sex with me. I don't even talk about sex in my comedy, but I can't, you know what? It's not it. There are certain things I'm going to fight in this world. They want to post that, use that same exact bit, but call it everyone wants to have sex with me. Go for it. Go for it. I don't have time to fight that. You know what? We've got bigger battles right now, and there's some real shit about to happen. And I just want you guys to know, if this channel doesn't get taken down, YouTube, if you don't take my channel down, everything is for entertainment purposes only, by the way. If you don't take the channel down, I'm going to share something tomorrow. I'm off for the next 5 days. So I have time now to focus on letting you guys know. If I'll share something tomorrow on my TikTok, but I'll also share it here, but you probably won't see it, but it's a big deal. It's important. And it has to do with the next year and a half of our lives and a report called the Dugan Report. You can look it up on your own, or I will share you a link, but it does say in the next year and a half, 70% of America is going to be, according to the numbers of the amount of people that will be alive here in America. Yeah, NATO. So the ones that are in NATO, just us and France and the UK, and so all that is predicted, but it could totally be false. It's predicted in a certain report you can look online by 2025, 70%, which is the exact amount that took the is going to be no longer. And that's by 2025. So I'm just saying, I watched a couple of videos today and this guy was like, please just love the people in your life. Just love, just focus on love. Don't convince anyone of anything. Don't try to, like, it's that time is past, guys. We don't have to do that anymore. It's over. They're not going to get it. If they didn't get it, I mean, get it, not get it. But if they didn't, then they won't. And that's okay. They're not supposed to, right? We don't know why we're here or why the people can't see what we see. Doesn't matter. We got to stop judging, stop putting them in the box. They haven't woken up, they're sheep or whatever. We just have to say, love, just love, 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 just love, because that is the only thing that's going to save all of us. Really, it's just a frequency that everyone has potential of. I do tours every day, and I would say 85% of humanity, they're just really good people, and we all just want the same things. And then the 15% other, they're Satan, and they've been in my car too, and I've had them in my life, and they are evil, and they will, like serpents, but right now, those people will fall away so fast. So fast. You won't even be able to have them in your life, even if you try. Those people are done. They're done. For you, in your life, they're done. You're elevating to another level, which I talk about on my TikTok as well. You are at a different level where people might not understand you, but it's not about that. It's about understanding, and it's about being authentic. The frequency of authenticity is actually stronger than love, because authenticity is, I will say this no matter what, but I'll still love you, but I'm going to stay strong in who I am. And that is truly the most honorable thing you can do, because that's your character. Your character. It's really, really, truly important because that's what you take with you. You don't take the money with you. The people I watch were in their 80s and they're so focused on money. It scares me. I'm like, where have you been? Like, how do you think that that will actually help you when you die? You think when you die and you cross over, which I did, they're going to talk about money? No, it's about experience. How did people feel when they were around you? How did you allow them to be? Did you accept them? Did you love them? Like, all that shit is the currency we're moving into. And that's a new earth. And that's another level. So I'll just end this. It's my favorite song. And sorry, you guys know I go like 2.5 hours. And now it's almost 3. So 2 hours, 45 minutes. We're going to end with, which I hope when I go live on Rumble or TikTok, I could, you know, end it with this. It's my favorite lyrics. Spirit leads. We don't lead. We think we do. You think you are in control, but you're not. Spirit leads. Whatever religion you believe in, there's a force outside of you that is guiding you. And if you're true to yourself, you're going to be protected and you're going to be okay. And that's the good news. That's the good news. So, yeah. But be humble. Be humble.
My left stroke just went viral.
Right stroke put little baby in a spiral. Soprano C, we like to keep it on the high note. It's levels to it, you and I know. Be humble.
Hold up.
Sit down.
Hold up.
Be humble.
Hold up.
Sit down.
Hold up, sit down.
Or don't sit down. But understand, spirit leads. Always, always, no matter what. You're safe, you're protected. I love you all. I don't have my glasses on, so I can't see your comments. But just know, douchey douche YouTube, you're over. You're done. Yeah, I denounce you from my life. I will no longer be on YouTube. Maybe 2 more live streams to then transition to move to a place that we're accepted and heard. Why would we continue in this abusive relationship with a platform that doesn't respect us, honor us? And what they did to Russell Brand, it confirmed things for me. We're going to leave here. Rumble's good. I'll figure it out. I'll figure out how to do live streams on Rumble, but I'll be in Rumble under, I think my name, Rachel Reinstra. I don't know. I'll let you guys know. I'll figure it out this week, but I love you all. Thank you for being here. And it's so weird. Now it's 15 people on YouTube and 10. It's like 10 on Facebook at 1 a.m, which is like 4 on the West Coast. I can't figure it out. Anyway, spirit leads. And I end all my live streams with this song. I love it. I love it. And if you don't feel anything when you hear this, please unsubscribe and never come to my channel again, because this is beautiful. This is a beautiful moment. And if you hear this song and you actually don't feel anything, please, please don't be in my reality. And if you do love it, stick with it. Enjoy the journey. We were supposed to be here for this. I think maybe I had like 3 martinis and I was asking to go to the bathroom and God's like, oh, you raised your hand. So you want to, no, I just want to go. Where's the bathroom? No. Oh, you want to come back to and all of a sudden I'm in my mom's vagina. I'm like, oh shit. I just wanted to pee. And then I'm here.
Spirit lead me when my thrust is out borders. Let me walk above. Wherever you would call me, take me deeper than my feet could ever wander, and my faith will be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
You call me out upon the waters, the great unknown. Where feet may fail, and there I find you in the mystery and oceans deep.
my faith will stay.
Oh. Your ways abound in deepest waters. Your sovereign hand will be my guide. Where peace may fall, I feel surrounded. You've never failed, and you won't stop now.
Spirit, lead me where my trust is with the waters. Let me look upon the waters, wherever you would call me. Take me deep, but my feet could ever wander, and my faith would be made stronger in the presence of my Savior.
Spirit, lead me. Spirit, lead me. Spirit, lead me. Take me deeper. Take me deeper. Take me deeper into you.
Why do you leave? I don't know where you're going to go. And you're gone for days, like 5 or 6 days. She's purring like crazy. Why? I don't know if I'm ever going to see you again. You just go. Oh God. Cats. You going to go again? There she goes. Teaching me about letting go. That's what animals do. All right. Love you guys. See you soon.